Hello students, today I am going to demonstrate floral dissection. And for this practical, I am using hand lens, blade, slide, needle and watch glass. For this practical, I am using this flower is China rose, which scientific name is Hibiscus rosa sinensis, belonging to the family Malvaceae. Now, we know the flowers has four roles, that are calyx, corolla, andricium and gynecium, okay. But in this flower we can find an extra role, that is known as apicalyx. See here, apicalyx is present and the number of apicalyx is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, okay. So this extra role is a special character of Malvaceae, which is found in Malvaceae. Now I am detached this apicalyx by using fingers. Here you can see 6 apicalyx are separated. Now the next role is calyx, okay. So here you can see there are 5 sepal, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. There are 5 sepals in calyx, okay. Now dissect is by using a needle. You also can use your pencil compass if you don't have needle in your house. Gently you use your fingers and can separate sepals, okay. Now this is calyx and we can find 5 sepals here, which are united with each other, okay. So this type of fused sepals are called gamosepals, okay. So these calyx are gamosepals and all the sepals are arranged one after another. There is no overlapping among the sepals. So this arrangement is called velvet aestivation. See this aestivation, you can separate it also. This velvet aestivation is found and 5 sepals are found. Now the next role is petal, okay. And here you can see the aestivation of petals also. Now have a look here. See, here we can see petals are overlapped with each other. See here, this petal is over this petal and next this petal is also over this petal, and this aestivation is called as twisted aestivation, okay. These are petals, twist aestivation is twisted, and we also can find the numbers of petals are 5. And these type of flowers are called pentameras, because here flowers, in these flowers sepals are also number in 5, petals are also in number 5. So these type of flowers are called as pentameras flower, which is a exclusive character in dicots. In case of dicots, number of sepals and petals or the roles of the flower may be 4 or 5 or the multiple of 5. Okay, so this is a dicot plant, and so here we can see the flowers are pentamers. Now I am separating petals one after another. And now here you can see another special character, that is, okay, let me separate these petals also. Now you can see that here this is andrachium, male reproductive part of this flower, okay, and the male reproductive part, that is andrachium, you can see is united with petals. See here is united with petals here, okay. So this type of arrangement is called as epipetalism. That means when the reproductive part, mainly the stamens, fused with sepals or petals, then this fusion is called adhesion. And here andrachium is, or male reproductive part is connected with or attached with the petals, and so this type of adhesion is called epipetalous condition of adhesion. Okay, that means how stamens attached with other role of the flower, how stamen it attached with the other roles of a flower. Now I am separating other petals by using fingers. After that we can use a needle. This is andrachium, and here this is the third role of this flower, andrachium, and here you can find this yellowish part. These are the anthers, okay. These are the anthers, and these are the anthers, and these are the filaments. And here, filaments joined with each other and form this stamen. And here, the stamens are fused. That is called as Monadelpha stamen, and is a special character of Malvaceae family flower. And also, you can see here the special shape of this anther, okay, kidney shaped anther. Here you can see this kidney shaped anther, and these and type of anthers are called as reniform anthers. After that, this is reniform anthers, and these are the stamens. This is a stamen, and here we can see this anther, which is kidney shaped and called reniform anther, and this is the filament, and filament are united and form staminal column. This is staminal column. Now I will split open this staminal column and will try to take out the last reproductive part or last fourth role of this flower, that is female reproductive part and gynoecium. We will have to use gently our needle and fingers to take off the gynoecium. See, here it is. This is the staminal column. Okay, this is the staminal column, and this is gynoecium. Male reproductive part or staminal column is here, and is the female reproductive part. okay, and here we can see number of stigma is also 5, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So it is pentamerous, of course, and number of stigma 5, which are united and form this style, and then it is ovary style and stigma, and here 5 stigma carpels are fused and form the ovary, and so fused carpels is called 5 carpels are fused, and so this fused type of carpels forming a ovary, and this type of ovary is called syncarpous ovary. And this is the female reproductive part of this flower, and we can see here male and female both reproductive part are present, and also calyx, corolla, male and female reproductive part, all the major 4 parts are present, and also apicalyx is present. So this type of flower is a complete flower, and male and female both reproductive parts are present, and so this type of flower is called as bisexual flower or hermaphrodite flower. Now I am going to perform the transfer section of this ovary, okay, and here I am using this blade, but before it I will have to take some amount, little bit amount of water on wash glass, and will perform transfer section of this ovary to see the arrangement of ovules on the ovarian wall, that is called as placentation. Here I can feel the mucilage secreting capacity of this flower. And can feel little bit difficulty. This. We take some fine sections from this ovarian portion, and here the reason of using water is we can understand which is the finest section, okay, which is the finest section we can understand by using little bit of water. And now I am showing you. See, this is the transfer section of the ovary, and we can see the placentation here. Placentation means the arrangement of ovules on the ovarian wall, okay, and see, this is the finest section, this is the finest section, and I will keep it on a slide and showing you. See, this is the sectional view of the ovary where ovules are come out. Ovules are also found, and this type of placentation is called as axial placentation. Okay. Now we can also perform transfer longitudinal section also by using a blade. Here how we can perform the longitudinal section, here you can see we will have to take this flower in such a way, we will have to hold this flower in such a way, and just gently use a blade to perform a longitudinal section. See. This is the longitudinal section of the ovary, and here you can find the total longitudinal section of the flower. See. This is the longitudinal section of the ovary. Okay. And this is the longitudinal section of the total flower. This is the longitudinal section of the total flower. Okay. This is the longitudinal section of the total flower. This is calyx. This is the longitudinal section of the flower. This is calyx, epicalyx, petals, corolla, andrecium part, gynecium part. This is the anus of ovary. Anus of ovary, and TS of ovary is here. By using a needle, I am taking a transverse section of the ovary. It's very slimy. A transverse section of ovary here. This is a transverse section of ovary. Anus of ovary, gynecium, corolla, epicalyx, calyx, longitudinal section of flower, and the andrecium. And here andrecium, this is anther. This portion is anther. This is staminal column. And in case of Malvaceae, we can find that here andrecium form a column that is called as Monadelphus from stamen. And here this is stigma. Is style and is ovary. So I think you can understand the dissection procedure of a flower. So thank you.